As India and Pakistan continue to argue over the release of Kulbhushan Jadhav, national security advisors from both countries are learned to have held secret talks in Thailand. This meet was described as friendly, according to the Pakistani media, but it still raises a lot of questions as to the direction of Indo-Pak ties. So what can we or what should we make of this meeting, and will it have any effect at all on the Kulbhushan Jadhav case? To discuss that, I'm joined by former Foreign Secretary Lalit Man Singh. Mr. Man Singh, thanks so much for joining us. That's my first question to you. What can we make of these talks that were held in Thailand of late?
Well, first of all, I'm a bit skeptical about these talks for the following reasons. Mm-hmm. One, there is no official confirmation from our side, and that is a bit odd. Secondly, an event like this would make the media go to town. Nobody has, to the best of my knowledge, even acknowledged that these talks have taken place. Thirdly, after the expression of displeasure over the treatment of the wife and mother of Kulbhushan Jadhav and the strong statement made by External Affairs Minister Mrs. Sushma Swaraj, it would seem rather odd timing for the two NSAs to meet quietly in Bangkok. There would be a lot of explaining by the government to do this. And finally, the two NSAs, as we know, met about two years ago, in Bangkok. Mm-hmm. And then after that, the hotline went cold. And our information was that nothing much was happening between the two NSAs. So I'm a little surprised and also a little skeptical. But let me put that aside. Supposing it is true, right, then what does it mean for us?
Yes.
Well, one, it would certainly mean that Pakistan feels cornered and diplomatically isolated, and therefore is changing tactics to make it appear as if Pakistan is being more reasonable with India, mm-hmm, and is making an overture,
right,
number one. Number two, it may mean that Pakistan feels that dealing with India and having tension with India is not sustainable, mm-hmm, especially as Pakistan is going through a period of domestic turmoil. The Prime Minister, Nawaz Sharif, has stepped down. Elections are coming up, and there's an air of uncertainty about what is going to happen in Pakistan.
Mr. Man Singh, the timing of this seems even more significant considering the developments in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case. It was just a couple of days after the families had actually met in Pakistan. There were so many questions raised in the manner in which that meet was conducted by Pakistan. Do you think it could have any sort of impact on that particular case?
I was coming to that.
Okay. Okay.
Assuming that this talks took place, mm-hmm, it could also mean something else. Remember that recently the Pakistan Army Chief, who actually is the de facto leader of Pakistan, had said openly that he will support any move by the Pakistani government to have better relations with India. That was a significant statement, except that people here were pretty skeptical and didn't take that seriously. But we also know that a couple of months ago, there was a meeting of the Pakistani Army Chief with a number of senior army commanders in Karachi, including a lot of corps commanders. And one of the Pakistani generals, in the presence of the Army Chief, declared that Pakistan should now make amends, have better relations with India, and build up economic cooperation with India. And our report suggests that the Pakistani Army Chief,
right,
not only did not oppose it, but seemed to endorse it. So if this is so, this is a new tack, a new signal being given by Pakistan. And maybe if the two NSAs met, they would take this further. I doubt if the issue will be the Kulbhushan Jadhav case, because there is nothing that the two governments can do. The matter lies entirely in the International Court of Justice in The Hague. I think it's a broader issue of Indo-Pak relations, the issue of terrorism on Afghanistan, and whether the two countries should now resume a dialogue and proceed further.
Right.
Or India gives its tough signal saying, you stop terrorism, otherwise there is no dialogue.
Right.
So I think we have to wait and see.
Absolutely, Mr. Mansingh. Really appreciate you joining us on Bloomberg Quint and sharing those insights. For all of you watching, thanks so much for tuning in to Bloomberg Quint and watching Prime Time Debate.